Welcome to Kane Space TV, for the fans, by the fans, and I'm one of those fans. I'm Esteban, and this is Break It Down.
Break it down. Break it down.
Why the U wins. Central Florida has not beat a team that currently is above 500. They also haven't lost to a team that's currently over 500. That's about as mediocre gets. So, Hurricanes having won four games, all against ranked opponents, one of which was in the subdivision, but still ranked opponent, and the one loss is against the number 4 team in the nation. Hurricanes should win. They should win big, at least by a couple touchdowns. Why the U needs to be careful. UCF's running back Bryn Harvey has averaged over 100 yards per game and will be counted on to keep UCF in the game this week, as well as to keep Ja'Cory Harris and the UM offense on the sideline. Key individual matchup, I'm going with UCF's defensive ends, Bruce Miller and Jarvis Gathers, versus the Hurricanes' O-tackles, Jason Fox and Matt Pipo. Miller and Gathers have combined for 9 sacks this year and are tied for 19th in the nation in that category. Fox and Pipo have been on the opposite spectrum so far this season, where Fox has been an All-American candidate, while Pipo has really struggled the past few weeks with Jason Worlds of Virginia Tech and Jeremy Beal of Oklahoma. It's going to be very important that Fox and Pipo can keep Ja'Cory Harris jersey clean. That way the offense can be as explosive as possible. The player of the game will be Leonard Hankerson. Without Darius Johnson out, Hankerson becomes the most consistent possession receiver. He should also get plenty of catches in the intermediate to long range. So, I'm looking for him to put up about 100 yards and one or two touchdowns, being Ja'Cory's primary target this week. Once again, I'm Esteban, and this has been another installment of Kane Space TV's Break It Down.